new information on the investigation. And it looks like crews have improved the highway there. They've cleaned up quite a bit.
Exactly. They have cleaned up quite a bit, but they still have a long way to go. And I want to point out, too, as I step back, we're going to be really careful here because crews have begun the heartbreaking task of trying to pull some of these victims from these cars. So we're specifically not going to show you certain areas of the crime scene at this point. I do want to show you guys, though, tow truck drivers all lined up here. Their first task, trying to remove this pickup that you can see positioned there. And another thing that we've been talking about is the driver of the semi. I want to point out that the Lakewood police said he was driving the flatbed truck. That is the one that you can see right there, right behind that white pickup truck that workers are getting ready to remove. Now, let's show you guys some other video of this crash from yesterday. Just incredible images coming into our newsroom. We know at this point that that driver is now facing vehicular homicide charges. We're not being told what specific evidence they're able to release, but they did say multiple witness interviews as well as gathering evidence out there has led them to believe that those were the right charges. And as you guys mentioned, that number has jumped up to 28 vehicles involved in this crash. We still don't know exactly the number of fatalities, but it is a lot of work out here trying to figure that piece out. Now, going back to that semi truck driver, here's what Lakewood police had to say about this investigation into the crash.
The driver of the semi that started this event was taken into custody. He is being processed and will be lodged at Jefferson County Jail on multiple counts of vehicular homicide. We feel at this time we have enough probable cause to charge the vehicular homicide charges. And so, like I said, the evidence is still being built, but there is enough probable cause at this time to support those charges.
Now, coming back out here live, I want to point out that they were able to just lift up this tow truck. And what you see underneath there is how it looks like the asphalt almost turned to like gravel. When CDOT's talking about how they need to repave the road after all of this gets cleaned up, that's why you have instances like this where it just burned so hot that now they're going to have to go back through and repave it. So not only investigators have to wrap up this scene, but that only then will crews be able to get out here and clean it up. So it is going to be a long time. No surprising that CDOT says it's going to not be open until tomorrow. Emily Allen, Fox 31.
Wow. All right, Emily, thank you for the